every brother was caught in the crossfire. Was caught in the crossfire.
Hey guys, it's Hayden and
Phil
from
Crossfire Collectibles.
And today we have a little draw haul for you guys. But we have some FSS, some other stuff.
Convention stuff, JoeCon.
And so let's get right into it. To start it off, I'm going to go ahead and show one of my Zombie Initiative figures, which is the Steel Brigade Commander. So this is cool. I do have pretty much all the Steel Brigades now. I still need the Zombie Steel Brigades. And I think that's it. I think there's like one more.
You need Steel Brigade Zombies and the Clutch and Ice Storm with the Rescue 4x4
Rescue Ops Van. So, this is one of the last Steel Brigades I need, so I'm going to be opening this up while my dad goes ahead and shows one of his figures.
Okay, I'm going to move on, starting with one of our first FSS figures for this video, and this is Windmill. Now, he wasn't a very popular character. If you guys had a Skystorm plane growing up, then you knew the pilot was Windmill. Now, it mentions the Skystorm on the back and blah, blah, blah with his file card. So I'm in the midst of, or process, I should say, of restoring a Skystorm. When I do, I may take him out and put him in and see how well he fits into it. It's cool. He's got the little helipack, whatever you want to call it. I remember when I was a kid, I had the Annihilator, and he came with that, and I just thought it was awesome. And then they reissued figures, and Matt Tracker came with the 25th version of it. But I guess the body is sort of okay. I think he's got a Wild Bill vest. Not sure who the legs are off the top of my head. And some random crap. The head looks like Duke, though. Not Duke, but like Doo-Doo Duke. He's just... Ew, I don't know what they were thinking. But yeah, so here you go. Here's FSS Windmill, and like I said, he probably will be opened, but if we do decide to open him, it's going to be when the Skystorm is finished, and we'll show you him out of the package with the vintage plane itself, and we'll let you know how that goes. You finished with the Steel Brigade Commander?
Mm-hmm.
Alright.
So he's pretty loose, but here's a Steel Brigade Commander. I do have this cool... zombie. It does have a Z on it, a little Z and a plus. I put his backpack on, has little like glitter gold painted shovel on it. These things like to fall off easily. He does have the pistol and the silencer. He does have his knife, and he has some removable knee pads. His helmet does come off. The rocket and the RPG does come out as well. He has this little assault rifle with a knife at the end.
Bayonet.
Another assault rifle. And a shotgun. So, he comes with the normal stuff a Steel Brigade would come with. But it is painted a little different. And I do like the RPG, so I went ahead and put that on him. So, yeah. Next up, I want to go ahead and show their cards first. But we do have the... Are they JoeCon?
Yeah.
We do have the JoeCon exclusive Slaughter's Marauders. Whoops.
Spirit, Footloose, and Mutt, and Junkyard.
So, we did show Hardball in a past video, but my dad has him. And I'm getting these.
Yeah. So, that would mean that Sergeant Smasher is missing, but he is not here yet. And we weren't going to show this whole set together anyway, so we'll show him as he comes in. Yeah, he's pretty much finished. If you remember in the last video, we were talking about who gets the Slaughter's Marauders and blah, blah, blah. He wanted the striped versions, the more real American hero style, you know, Dick series colors. So I took the ones that came in the BBTS pack, and he'll get the Taurus. I keep Taurus Bull, whatever they called him. It was Taurus, but they renamed the Bull, but I think the other figure they renamed... They finally put the proper Taurus name on it, Red Dog, and not Mercenary this time again, just Mercer. So he'll get the Slaughter Marauder colors of those. I'm going to keep the traditional ones from the G.I. Joe animated movie. Oh, look at that. Oh, you got to pull it down somewhere, I forgot. But yeah, it's pretty slick. So got a few things here. I have the Collector Club Footloose. Let me see. I have the regular Slaughter's Spirit. I have the 25th Spirit. The 50th two-pack Spirit. And then, of course, the POC Billy from Predator Spirit. That's what I call him, Billy, for sure. But I like the Spirit that came with this one. It's cool. He's got it. Because that's the Spirit I had when I was a kid. I had the Slaughter Marauder one. I did not have the original Spirit. Just could never find him when I was a kid. But then again, I was like, 4 or 5 years old. But this one looks slick. And pretty sure Mutton Junkyard, they're just repaints of the 25th figure. But he'll get to him. He's opening them. I just figured I'd run my mouth for a minute, so kill some time. But he's almost finished that.
Okay, so here's Footloose. He does come with a bunch of stuff. He comes with this giant backpack that holds his flashlight, his machete, and his pistol. Here he has a RPG, the same one that Bazooka comes with. And here I have him reloading his assault rifle. He comes with a little helmet with looks like some grass on it. But the grass is not colored, it's just all black. And yeah, so that is Footloose. He comes with a brown stand instead of the usual black. But that is the Slaughter's Marauder's Footloose. And I'll be moving on to the next figure, which will be Spirit and Freedom, while my dad shows his next figure.
All right, so the next figure, this is pretty much almost the end of our Ninja Force figures. And here we have the FSS Nunchuck. Yeah, Nunchuck was one of my favorites as a kid. I started moving out away from the Joes when they started getting a little into the goofy stuff. Night Force started it with the colors and all, and then, you know, they had the eco figures, and it just, like, all them vibrant and pastel colors coming out, they didn't sit with me too well. But Nunchuck was always cool. This one looks a lot better, but you can tell right off the bat, he's got the, you know, he's just got a masked face on. I'm not sure who exactly it is, because I'm not going to take this out yet anyway. But he's got the head from Temple Guardian, Snake Eyes, POC, and he's got a pair of nunchucks, got the little the wrist darts, pair of swords, I guess it's a katana and a tanto, maybe. And it's kind of cool because it actually has a pouch on the sheath. So I don't think any of the other figures I have that. He's got two sides, and he's got a code name nunchuck stand in there. So yeah, but he's pretty slick. When I was a kid, I had his, and I think I teamed him up with Hit and Run just because the colors were similar, and they're like, oh, look, a ninja and a mountain climber. So, but yeah, he was cool. I'm glad to finally get this in the collection, and that means we're only two away from completing the whole Ninja Force way. Once we have everybody here, we'll go ahead and do a video of just Ninja Force to show you everything. And doesn't necessarily have to be an FFS, you know. FSS can be you know, some of the exclusives with G.I. Joe Transformer crossover with Scarlet and all them, and just like the dollar store Snake Eyes and Storm Shadow, and yeah. He'll go ahead and explain Spirit here in a second. Kind of trouble?
Okay, so here's Spirit with Freedom. I went ahead and put Freedom on his backpack. And he comes with two cartridges that he goes in his little rifle. So he has one in his rifle right now. He does come with an extra knife, but there's nowhere to put it. So I might put it in his other hand or just sit it on a stand. He, for some reason, he has a built-in knife on his strap right here. I don't know why they couldn't just make that a holster for this knife. But it looks kind of cool. I'm going to go ahead and put this knife in his hand.
I put it backwards where he's holding it. He's like, oh, you come near me, I'm going to elbow slash you. Hell yeah.
So he is holding his knife. He is going to be back heavy. Yeah. So I'm going to have to lean him forward a bit. Okay, there we go. So there is Spirit and Freedom. And lastly, we have Mutt and Junkyard. So I'm going to go ahead and open this up when my dad shows the next figure.
Okay. Well, should we just do that one?
You can do it.
Okay. All right. So, like I said, we were close to the end of our Ninja Force. And here's one more. And here's the FSS Dojo. Dojo was... I think they only had, like, what, 6 or 7 Ninja Force figures growing up. He was one of them. The ball-headed guy. I always thought he was Dr. Mindbender when I was a kid. And I'm just like, who is it? Who is it? I don't think I had him. My cousin did. I know he did. I didn't really want him. So, I don't think I had him anyway. But anyway, it's just cool to get them all again, you know, and seeing them. But he takes the most of the Ninja Force with him. I keep very few. Like, I have Scarlet. If you saw in the past video, him and I did the paper, rock, scissor for it. Rock, paper, scissor, paper, rock, scissor.
Whatever. I won, but we ended up trading.
Did you win? Oh, yeah, you did win Scarlet. But yeah, we traded. He wanted something else. He wanted the Scarlet from the one San Diego pack that came with Power Glide. Mm-hmm. But he ended up getting her. I got Zartan. And I got Scarlet out of it, too. But anyways, so yeah, there he is, FSS Dojo. He's got a little dingy hook. It's like kind of ripped. His file card once again. I always thought he was a bad guy too. But anyway. So yeah, there's, like I said, we almost have them all. Now we just need to show you off Budo and Zartan. Ninja Force Zartan. And that'll do it for the Ninja Force. We'll show that in one of the next videos coming up, probably in the next week or two.
Okay. So here's Mutt and Junkyard. As you guys can see, it is the newer dog style. It's not like the old one. So this is like the one I think came with one of the Baroness.
No.
But he has his mask on.
Mutt's, I got him on one of the shelves in there, but he's behind some of the others. I have, like, certain shelves separated by years that they were on, like, the class of 83, the class of 84, you know. Oh, he's on one of them.
So he comes with the brown stand that says Mutt and Junkyard. He comes with a little, looks like an Uzi with a silencer on it. He comes with, I don't know, maybe something to shock the dog or something. Or, like, freaking baton. I don't know what that is. He comes it's with, like, a little helmet.
It's like a weighted... Billy Club, pretty much.
To hit him?
To hit, he would never hit the dog.
Oh. Well, he comes with a mask, and he comes with this little knife, but I don't have it in his hand. But he comes with that. And you then know, here's the dog.
It looks like a pirate knife. I found one of these a while ago, and I thought it was a Lego knife, and I'm like, what? But no, it's a Joe knife. But I mean, that was like the old school stuff, if I remember properly. But, eh.
All right.
We each got one thing to show. He's going to finish off the Slaughter's Marauders and show you what we got.
Okay, so here is the Slaughter's Marauders, I guess, ammo crate. We do not know what's in this.
I haven't looked at no reviews or nothing.
I don't know what's in this, so we're going to go in and open it up and see what's in it.
Not much.
Not much at all.
We figured it had a bunch of stuff in it, like how Danger of the Docks did with the night landing. It came with a little crate and had tons of weapons in it. This has, what, 4 weapons?
So, not even really... Like, more like 3. It comes with a axe. It looks gray on camera, but it is brown in real life. Shovel.
It does look gray, but it's they're brown. They're definitely brown.
A little machine gun. And another machine gun. Doesn't come with that much. Still cool, though.
$20 for that, really?
For this?
Yeah.
So I could have this.
Show the logo.
Oh yeah, it has Slaughter's Marauders on the front, which is a pretty cool add-on. So I'll go ahead and move the SBC and have these three over here with it in front of them. Have like a little setup of them three. Mm-hmm. And yeah, so that's all for my characters, but my dad does have one more.
I got one more right here. It's so good to finally get this guy loose. Oh man, I've had him on card several times, and his price was always bouncing around, and I found people who were like, oh man, well, I need that, I'll trade you for this, I'll trade you for that. Well, I got this one on eBay, don't judge me, and the guy was like, yeah, is this much your best offer? I made an offer, he counter-offered, I counter-offered back, And he accepted it. And he was like, well, this one has a bunch of extra accessories in it.
I've seen a lot of custom 6-inch figures of this figure.
But I'm just going to show you the figure. I got the FSS Big Boba. Finally a loose one. Now, it's awesome to get this guy back, and especially with all this stuff he has with him. Now, he doesn't have the full card back, but he does have his file card. So that's cool. That's here. Now, one of the things that really I said okay about, you know, he was fully complete. Now, here's his stand. But he came with extra accessories. And these are all Big Boba accessories. So his normal ones are his boxing gloves. And they aren't like the old A Real American Hero style. You don't just slide the glove over his hand. These ones, you actually unpeg his hand. And inside of the boxing glove, has a peg into it.
You could have him going against like a Cobra Trooper, like training him.
Yeah, plugs right on into his arm. He's like,
that's cool. I like that better.
Okay, now here's some of the cool stuff. He comes with 2 jousting poles, 2 multi-weight dumbbells, sort of like that Bowflex stuff. Whatever, you can put whatever weight you want to use in and pick it up, and it leaves with down. Mm-hmm. 2 sledgehammers. And 2 protective masks. So grab a figure and let's do a size comparison. Just pop one on, take one of their helmets off. I don't think I got anybody like nearby. Well, we showed him in the last video. I haven't done nothing with him yet. You guys remember we showed off Roll Bar. I got some custom stands coming. Well, not stands, but some custom decals to go on the stands. It's basically just the water type stuff. You know, you cut the piece you want, dip it in the water, then rub it on here and dry it off, and bam, you got your own custom stand. Had a bunch of custom names made, and had a bunch of classic names made for some people that didn't have stands. So that's pretty cool. But here we go. We have Roll Bar. I explained in the last one, he is, they gave him an airborne head repaint. So we'll take the little protective, I guess, dueling helmet on, sparring helmet. Pop that on him. And give him one of these jousting poles.
Wait, why does he come with a sparring helmet if you can't even put it on him?
What do you mean?
Why does he come with this if
he doesn't? I said the dude who I got this from gave me extra accessories. Like, he had 2 big bows or
something.
Oh, this
didn't even come with him? This didn't even go with
Big Boba? No, it came with him, yeah. But it was for somebody who he's training.
Oh, you can put it on a Cobra Trooper.
I know, but I'm saying. So that's why he came with the extra stand and other stuff. So if you got another figure, you could set them up and have a... Nah, man, Big Boba won't use one of those. Or maybe you would one-handed be like, I'll take you on. Here. See? Ding, 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 ding. And then... Boom! Cobra! Yeah, awesome. Let's do a size comparison too. Just try to stand him up, because Big Boba, he has a larger body. I wouldn't say he's as big as Roadblock. I don't have Roadblock out here, but
oh yeah,
yeah, he's close to a Roadblock size though. I don't think he's as big as the new one though. That new one's pretty definitely a little.
He's probably like 6.5, like he's
about
4.5 maybe.
He's about 4.5 inches tall. I'd say, yeah, I'd say probably 5.
I don't think 5.
Yeah, definitely.
Because those are 6 inches.
Yeah, my hand is almost 4, so he's...
Like, he's 4.5. Maybe he's over 4. Maybe, like, 4 and, like, what's above a half?
3/4.
3/4? He's, like, 4 3/4 tall. Mm.
Okay, anyway. So, yeah, that'll do it for this video.
So...
mini haul, but, It's got his exclusive rights, so we figured we'd show him off. Like Tarn in the background, just did a video with him right before we did this one. So we're gonna go in. That was a solo version with me, so we'll get that up too. But here's this one, and we're kind of looking forward to this weekend. We're actually doing another sort of mini video for this weekend. It'll be X-Men Marvel Legends exclusive.
Stay tuned. I'm excited for that video. But that's pretty much it for today's video. So if you guys did enjoy this video, make sure to giant thumbs up, subscribe, hit the bell notification so you don't miss a video. Make sure to follow us both on Instagram at everything.diijoe.
This is 127.
And Crossfire X Collectibles. And we'll see you on the next one. Peace.